Nope, it won't. Run! Hi, friends! How are you? This is the Chaldonut speaking, and welcome back to some more ARK Survival Evolved. First off, everybody, I'd just like to talk for a minute here about the Survival of the Fittest event that happened this past weekend. If you don't know, I got to participate in an ARK Survival of the Fittest game run by several YouTubers. Zuljin, Slipgator, and Zuma was a guest that they had on. It was super fun. I had a great time. It's on the channel if you want to check it out. And it was just an awesome time. It was a super cool game. So fun. Very exciting stuff. So if you did watch it, please let me know if you enjoyed watching, because it's something that I wasn't sure about putting on the channel, not this particular game, but ARK Survival of the Fittest in general. So please let me know if you enjoy that kind of content, guys, because otherwise I have no way to know. That's the point. Anyway, for those of you who have not watched yet, I recommend you check it out. It was a super fun game, very exciting, lots of action. I survived for a pretty long time, too. It's not like I played and died 5 minutes in. So, please do check that out. But anyway, let's get to the business at hand. ARK has released a number of updates since our last episode, and there's some really cool stuff in the game to check out that we haven't looked into. So I learned some new engrams, and we're going to look into all this stuff today. Anyway, we need to get some wood and some hide and stuff quickly, so I'm gonna grab all that wood, thatch. I think we just need that much. No, we can't jump. Shoot. I think I need hide, not fiber. So I'll grab both, though. I'll need both in the grand scheme of things here, so I'm gonna grab some materials. Here we go. And then we are going to head down and make some new stuff today. So, the first new thing, this is a really big one. They have added the raft. This thing is insane. It's super, super cool. It's very fast, and there's a lot of cool features with it. But I'll explain more when we get out onto the water with this thing. It crafts very slowly. That's pretty impressive. And then we did jump up a couple hundred XP there, so that's cool. Anyway, the raft is very heavy. I don't know if you saw, but 85 weight? That's crazy. Anyway, let's head out onto the water here, and we're going to check this out. So, we can place it down when we're in the water. And I guess maybe we'll read the tooltip. Floating wooden platform can support the weight of structures and be built on. That's the big feature, guys. Oh my gosh, it's so cool, guys. Check this out. You can see it's got a health bar, so it can be destroyed, and it's got weight, so when you place structures and things on it, gradually, I presume that weight bar is going to increase. Oh my gosh, check this out, guys. It's so fast. Alright, it probably doesn't beat an Ichthy in terms of speed, but I think it would definitely beat a Megalodon. And, why is that how far out Anchor's supposed to be? I guess it is, yeah. About right. Anyway, it's very fast, considering that you can put a ton of stuff on it, and it's pretty big generally already. It is quite fast, so that's awesome. Anyway, the really cool part about this is, if we hop up here onto the beach and hop off, what's really cool, I mean, first of all, you just have a platform, so you can just be out here on the water, I think, and just kind of hang out. But then also, we can place stuff, as it said in the description. So, here's something that would be very exciting. I don't know if we even need to place the foundation, but we could put a bed down. Check this out, guys. And now we have a mobile respawn point. That's pretty cool, right? Now, oh, can I? Oh, right, I can't back up. This is gonna get glitchy. Okay. But we can spawn anywhere we want to. presumably, assuming this works, I am going to rename the bed, though, so we know what it is. I'll call it Raft Bed. So now, I could travel pretty much anywhere if I was going on the raft. Say we were going to do a cave exploration. We could just bring the raft bed up the river where we needed to go. And then we could take it and just, if we die, respawn right there. And that would be much more convenient because we don't have to bring materials to make a new bed or worry about getting a foundation down or anything like that. We've got everything we need right here. So this is awesome. Something that would be interesting. Aw, never mind. I was hoping we could maybe get this boat into the Ichthy pen. That's not going to happen, though. I don't think a dino gate's big enough to go for this to go through. Right? Slow down. Yeah, it's not big enough. Never mind. So we can't do that. That's too bad. But this thing is awesome, guys. This presents us with a lot of opportunities. So that's cool. I want to go check out the roofing, though. At some point, we'll probably spend some time building cool stuff on the ramp. Not the ramp, the raft, excuse me. Anyway, let's see. Let's hop up here. Onto the roof, maybe? Well, first we need to make some stuff. We need to get some stacks of wood and thatch. And then wood, okay. So we're going to want wood roofing, which is right there. Sloped wooden roof. Pretty expensive, but that's what we want to have. And then we want sloped wood walls, I think. But really, before we play around with this, it might be better to get some thatch stuff, since it's not so expensive and we can make sure we're doing this right. So I think basically the way this works is, we take this stuff right here. So if we go on a foundation with a sloped thatch wall, like that, you see how it is? Basically, you can just dump this right on top, like that, and then I think, yeah, okay. So that's pretty much all there is to it, but it's very useful. Now we need to decide what we want to do with our roof. I've been thinking about a couple of things we could do here. I don't know if we have the materials to do all of it right now, but we could get a start on it. I think we're going to want to get rid of this thing, this stuff in the front here. But before we do it, my general plan would be, to have some roofs going up into the middle. I don't know what we'll do in the back here. We'll have to revise things a little bit. But we'll have roofs going up in the from each side here. And then we'll have kind of an opening up on the top level. And this can kind of be an attic area. And then up top, we'll have like some openings in the roof that go on to a couple ceilings. And then those will kind of act as a balcony to land birds and pteranodons. And then maybe we could put some fences up there, because there is a little trick you can do with fence foundations to allow you to place them so that they look like actual fences. So those are some things we could try. First things first, we're going to need to demolish this stuff, but really, we want to get these materials from these ramps, so we're going to start by demolishing them. Can I get up there? If I hop on the cooking pot, I bet I can. Think I've done this before, right? Anyway, we're going to try to do a little bit of building here. Tell you what, I'll make a cut, do a little bit, and then show you the concept. So, I'll be back. Okay, everybody, I've got a ton of materials now in my inventory. Lots of structures. Can I close this door? I kind of want to. Yeah, there we go. Okay. So, let's get out the materials. I don't have enough to really make too much progress, but I thought I'd bring a few things up just to do a little experimenting. Got four sloped wood wall left, four right. That's enough to do, I think, the whole building. Actually, I didn't need quite as many sloped walls for the back, did I? That's a mistake. Oh, well, we only needed seven sloped walls total. But the point is we need four of them for this side and three of them for the back, because they need to go on top of a set of walls right below, and then right below the roof. So, we only need one per column, so to speak, which is nice. Anyway, moving on from that, let's start to play around with this stuff. So, sloped wall right. We want it. No, that's not right. Okay, so we want it to go there. Uh-huh. Cool. Okay. And then we'd put our sloped wooden roof right on top of that. Okay? That how we do it? Cool. Okay. Wait. Oh, no! No, 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 that's not good. Actually, that might be good. Hang on. That might be cool. I wasn't planning on doing that, but that might actually look really nice. Oh, yeah, it will, guys. That's going to look cool. That is going to look very, very cool. I think we should do that. I think we should definitely do that. Okay. Spontaneous decision there, but we're going to go with it. I think that will actually make the building look quite a bit nicer. If we come out an extra layer, it's going to make the building a bit more expensive to finish off, but I think that's cool. So, can I place it here? Or can I not do that? Oh, I can't do it until there's another sloped wall. Never mind then. Seven, let's put that away. And then I need to drink some water, so let's do that. These water skins are really leaking way too much. I need to switch to water jars, but they take cementing paste, and I don't want to use cementing paste. I don't feel like putting in the time right now. Someday I will have to make a canteen. That's the ultimate goal, but anyway, that's for later. Now, let's get some more stuff placed. So, we need a wood wall right here. Yep, okay. Then we need a sloped wall. Like that. Okay, great. Now we want this right here. Okay, great. And then we want to come down the other way. That's not what I want. We want to go like this. Alright, cool. And then we want to switch sloped walls for now. Go with left. Okay. Great. Good, okay, we're doing fine. Let's get the sloped roofs out. And we can get the front done. And, come on. Boom! Okay, so that is the front of the base. It's looking good. Okay, let's light it up so you can kind of see what it's looking like. We're going to need pillars, I think. I like the idea of having it come out that way. But I don't know if I like it super... I don't know how if I like it super well. Anyway, that was a little bit of a strange way to phrase that, super well. Let's back up. Let's back up here. On Ellie. Yeah, I can see that. I think if we were gonna do that, though, what we really need is to come down one more. Can I not come down one more unless there's a sloped wall, really? Wow, that's a limitation of the building system. I wanted to come down one more without a sloped wall, but apparently I can't do that. I was thinking that would look pretty nice if it extended down further. Than the actual building, but it looks like the only way to do that is to place a sloped wall, and I don't really want one there. I may not even be able to do it. There may not even be foundation support. It may not work that way. There may have to be foundations directly below it. Who knows? I have a sloped wall right. I probably want a sloped wall left, correct? So, maybe that'll work? Nah, I don't think it will. Okay, so it looks like we can't do roofs outside the actual walls of the building there. But I think this part is going to be okay if we just get some pillars going. I think that could look really nice. Don't know where I want to put them, though. I think I know. Okay, I got it. So we're going to go pillar there, cooking pot there. That's going to be the change. So I'm going to do that. And then I'll show it to you, and then we'll move on to maybe some taming for this episode. I'm working on putting the finishing touches on the roof here. It certainly doesn't look super finished, or not the roof, the balcony, sorry. Doesn't look super finished, I will be honest. Let's see, is that the right way? I think that's the right way. Yeah, okay, it's the right way, great. And I've been redoing this because this pillar was actually going to block our ladder onto the second floor. And the ladder actually serves a very important function. And it's not at all utilitarian. It actually is not useful in that sense. It does, however, add visual interest to the front of our building, which is something that we were kind of lacking. In this way, you know, there's more to look at in the front. And don't worry, I haven't forgotten about that last ceiling, guys. I know that looks really weird, so we are going to get our ceiling down right now. Put that in. Then we're going to put down another pillar, I think. What? You can't put pillars there? Then what's the point of having roofs if you can't put things next to them? That's just dumb. Really, guys? You can't put pillars up by the roofs? That makes no sense. Let me see if I can do it from the top. Because my idea here, guys, was I was going to put these pillars in the roof like that, and it would make them look cool. You see what I'm saying? They'd come up. I do this in Minecraft all the time when I build. I don't build as often as I used to, but when I build buildings, I like to have these wood corners that kind of look like they're supporting the roof, and they come up above the roof, and that makes it look more interesting. But apparently we can't do that because the roofs aren't super advanced, so that's too bad. But hey, building an ARK isn't great. That's not why you play the game, though. Anyway, last thing. Since the pillars were a bust, I was hoping to get a cooking pot down, but I don't know if we actually will have any place to put this thing, because this is kind of a bad spot. This is not a great spot. We can't put it in front of the door. Can I put it there somewhere? No, not really. Not until I get to, like, right there, which doesn't work. I can put it on top of the trap door, but that's kind of dumb. So I think for now, we'll leave the cooking pot on the inside of the house, which is not really what I want to do, but that's okay. I wanted to have cookouts on the porch, but, well, I mean, technically, that wasn't even the porch. This is the porch. But I wanted to have cookouts. We can't really do that. We'll have cook-ins instead. That's fine. I guess we'll dump it right there for now. There we go. We have a cooking pot. That's all good. And we'll leave some structures behind now for the time being. We'll come back to the building. It's an ongoing project. We'll finish it in the future. But I wanted to get some work done since they'd added some new stuff to building. That was going to make our house look cooler. So that's what we did. Anyway, let's see here. Need to put my blueprint back, put these recipes into here, and then what I want to do, guys, is I want to go tame a Pachycephalosaurus, because that's a really cool new dinosaur. It's a pretty well-known dinosaur, too, so it's surprising that it wasn't in the game yet. But basically, they're these dinosaurs with really, really, really hard skulls, so they can headbutt stuff, including each other. And in ARK, what that means is they have this charge attack that does incredible amounts of, that deals incredible torpor to enemies, which is very useful for knocking out dinos and taking out other players. And it looks like I forgot to dump off some structures. Oops. Anyway, right, I came up here to drop off this blueprint for the trap door that I was carrying around. So I will dump that in here. There we go. And I saw I had enough for a saddle of some kind. What was that? Oh, Fiomia saddle. Never mind. I was curious. Now, let's see here. Right, I gotta drop off these structures to decrease our weight. Let's see. And that thatch foundation. And now our weight's looking pretty good. It's only at 80. So, what we're gonna do is, we're gonna take our narcotics. I've been making up a few more. shouldn't need more than this for herbivores. It's only, like, spinos and stuff that really take this much. And, ooh, we've got a Rex egg. Awesome. I don't even know what takes Rex egg eggs for their kibble. Which is something we haven't actually looked into at all. We haven't tried out kibble in this game. It's actually a really effective way to tame dinosaurs. It's several times more effective than prime meat on carnivores and, like, way better than berries on herbivores, because they don't have, like, a prime meat level to their taming. So, kibble's really awesome. You make it with, like, meat jerky and some berries and fiber, eggs, sometimes very dangerous eggs to get, such as Rex eggs. Anyway, that's just a little rant there. The goal for this episode is going to be, or for the rest of this episode, is going to be to take Avery and go find one of the new dinosaurs that has been released in the recent updates. There are some Gigantopithecuses, which are giant apes. You've got Pachycephalosauruses, which we just talked about. Mesopithecus is a poop-throwing ape, which is very interesting. And then we've got the Dodicarus, which was another recent addition that I believe was shown in our last episode of ARK. I can't remember if I cut the clip or not. But that one is for harvesting stone. And it kind of looks like the Ankylosaurus. Now it looks like, yep, we can get a level. I've been boosting melee damage because I want Avery to be able to farm prime meat when we go on little taming missions. And anyway, we're pretty much all set here. Got a couple stacks of Mayo berries. And Avery can already farm prime meat reasonably well, so I think we're all set here. I'm going to go find something cool to tame, and then we're going to tame it. Check this out! We can barrel roll. This is amazing. Did you see that? Did you see that? Look at that! I don't know how it decides how fast you get to go. It must be based on your current speed, because check it out, man. We can do all kinds of stuff. Oh, we're out of stamina now. Uh-oh. That's too bad. I just wanted to show that to you. I don't think that was a very good reveal, but that's okay. Because we can barrel roll, and that's just awesome. It takes a lot of stamina, though, it looks like. Although I didn't let Lydia recharge all the way. That's true. Let's actually look here. Let's do a little bit of analysis. And then I'll go back to taming, but hang on. Basically, you press C, and then you do the barrel roll. Doesn't use too much. I mean, it uses a lot more than normal flying, but it's not too bad. Yeah, so anyway, you press C, and it's actually pretty high power. You do a good bit of damage, and was that a SARCO I just saw? Yeah, it was. All right, I'm going to have to kill that guy. Oh, actually, no, we can tame that guy. I haven't tamed a SARCO yet. That would be fun. Okay, everybody, be on passive. I need to whistle all passive. Hang on, what's that? That's semicolon, isn't it? Hang on. Everybody just stay calm. All the people who could actually die pretty quickly are inside the gates. That's the fun taming we're going to do this episode. I wasn't certain right away, but that's what we'll do. Up. Weapons, ammo, trank arrows. What do I need? Narcotics. Oh, they're on Avery. Crap. I want to tame this SARCO. I think that'd be fun. And then next episode, I guess we'll go for a Pachy. Because we don't have a whole lot of time this episode. And the Sarco's right there. And we don't have one yet. And I've heard they're pretty cool. So, we might as well, right? And then let's get these items. Trank arrows, craft 47, go for it. Let's do this. Then I would like to hop on Avery quickly and just check it out. See what we see. Where is this guy? Where'd he go? Okay, let's scout while we're crafting all these arrows up and can't really move that fast. Okay, there he is. He's right there along the coast. I want to land back in here so that everybody here is safe. Then let's get the bow out. Let's put the trank arrows on. And then our weight's looking okay. I should probably drop some things. I can drop this. I can drop the wood. That'll help out. Okay. That'll allow us to run a little faster because I don't want to run out of stamina, or, well, not run out of stamina, but I don't want to be caught by a Sarco. That would be pretty bad. Fortunately, we've got plenty of beds nearby, so that wouldn't be too big a deal. But anyway, there you are. Okay, let's do this. Did I hit him? No, the music didn't play. Okay, come on. Uh-oh, lag. Come on, Sarco. I don't even know where he is. I can't tell. It's very hard to see him. I don't see him. Where did he go? I'm tempted to go in the water, but that feels like a really stupid move. Where is he? There he is. Alright. Oh! Mega Piranha! Oops. Crap. That startled me. Die. Okay. Come on, Sarco. Oh, not another one. Dang it. How many of them are there? Gosh. Just keep coming. Come on, Sarco. Come on. Did I hit you? No. Yes! Finally! Okay, get out of the water, get out of the water. Wait for it to come to me. Oh! I said I was gonna wait for it to come to me and then didn't do it. Okay. Let's see, K-mode, check it out. Got plenty of space. We're much faster than that, that's the good news. This is gonna be challenging, though. Back up, back up, back up, run! Don't think these guys are willing to go back to the water just because you take them too far away. I think they'll chase you forever, given the opportunity. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna let them chase us forever, practically. Can we get on this rock, actually? Will that stop him? I doubt it. Nope, it won't. Run! Shoot, I missed. Dang it. Oh, we got him! Okay! Level 34 female. Not bad, frankly. Level-wise, that's pretty good. Nice. Okay. Our first Sarco, guys. That's pretty awesome. Now let's whistle neutral to everybody so they go back on alert. That went pretty well. I'm going to see this girl through the taming process and then... Oh, shoot. Everybody neutral. Go, Ellie, go. All right. There we go. Okay. Calm down, Scarlet. You don't need to eat everything. Okay, come on. Get back over here. Alright, anyway, I'm gonna go get this Sarco tamed. See you in a bit. Okay, everyone, I got 7 prime meat for the Sarco on Oedipus, which is not the quickest thing to do. Oedipus is not super mobile. So I'm hoping it hasn't woken up. Please, please, please don't be awake, Sarco. Okay, it's still there. I see its body. Alright, great. She's still there. Let's check on the torpor. What's it looking like? Fine. It's great. Okay. Excellent. Okay. We're going to take all this prime that we've just farmed up. It's quite a bit. Actually, it looks like... No, it's just 7. I thought it was 8 for a second. Melee damage on Oedipus. Keep pumping that. Now, let's dump some food in. Okay. Great. Okay. Awesome. She's eating a lot of it. And is pretty close to being tamed. About halfway done. 4 prime meat, so we don't have quite enough. There's a Carno! Excellent! Okay. Thank you, for contributing, Carno. Let's go, man. So I'm gonna kill this thing, and then I guess I could kill that Bronto, too, if I don't get any prime off the Carno. Yep, I can do that. Got one prime. Not enough. I should probably... That's a Packy! Oh my gosh, guys, we just found a Packy! That's amazing! Okay, change of plans. Stupid bugs! You add nothing to the game. I just watched the footage back. The Packy got killed by a stupid Meganeura. Oh my gosh, I hate those guys. Man, I was really excited. We were gonna get a Packy. It was gonna be awesome. That was one of my original goals for the episode. It was gonna be so cool. And then, blah. That sucks, man. Alright, well, I'll tame the Sarco, but then that's all the time I've got, so we'll just have to settle for that. Not a bad tame. It's a pretty high level one, given our difficulty setting. So, overall, pretty good day. And I'll bring you back in when the Sarco's done. Here we go, everyone. The Sarco is just about tamed here. About maybe 15 seconds or so, and it's going to get tamed. And then that's going to be the episode, because we spent a long time doing some cool stuff. We made the raft. We'll play around with that more in a later episode, because there's a lot we can do with it. We did some fun building. And I had a great time with that. I think the roofs are a great addition to the game. There's still some things that could be done to make them better, but it's a work in progress. We're still technically in early access. So, anyway, we just got the Sarco. All right. Just going to take a look at the dossier here. Normally, I just close it, but I actually have never seen the Sarco dossier, so I'm kind of curious. Much faster in water. Okay. Very important. Good at fighting megalodons. Patient killing machine. Alright. I don't need to see much more here. So, I don't actually know what I'm gonna name this Sarco yet. Tell you what, guys. You guys can post suggestions for names in the comments below. I will continue to think of names myself as well. And then, when it is time for the next episode, we will go ahead and give this Sarco a name. So, I'm going to bring her back over here, and then that is all we're going to do for this episode. So I hope you have enjoyed, guys. Please remember to like and subscribe if you did. This has been the Chaldonut speaking goodbye, friends. And I will see you all next time with some more ARK Survival Evolved.